Hello and welcome back to No BS. Today we turn to talking about the streaming platform called Hulu. Hulu has recently released a new show and it seems like they're trying to compete with Netflix to see who can get the most woke. Yeah, typically we're talking about Netflix or HBO streaming services and sometimes even Disney Plus. And I think that Hulu has got the message and have noted that, hey, we need to get in on this woke trend. We need to make some more pro-leftist, very, very biased and political shows. And that's what we're talking about today. Today we have a new show coming out from Hulu and it's called Woke. That's it. That's the name. Full stop. The show's called Woke and they're basically trying to get in on this trend of everything being woke this year, everything being pro-left and just this whole kind of biased political influence that is infecting all of our media. Like not just the news, not just the TV. We're talking about movies, shows, streaming services. We're talking about comic books, video games. Like everything's getting dominated by this political agenda coming from the left, coming out really strong this year, probably because of the election, definitely because of the election. Keep in mind, everything that happens during an election year is because of the election. So that's what's really going on. And that's why we're talking about this new show. As you can see from this article promoting it, it says, is Hulu's newest original Woke the perfect show for our times? I would say yes and no. I mean, it's definitely a relevant topic. It's a relevant name, but for all the wrong reasons, you know, I think Woke started off as a positive thing and it still could be that way in a pure sense. I mean, being woke is meaning you're awake. It means you are aware of the truths of the world. And in the most basic sense, that just means, hey, you know that there's problems out there. There's things that we need to fix. You're aware of the way things really are. And if you just put it in a simple term like that, it's not really bad. But as we've seen with other terms that the left has used, other things that they've claimed, it's not exactly what it seems. It's like with feminism or equality or cultural appropriation. Like those terms have normal meanings that could be reasonable, but the left takes them to the extreme and perverts them and makes them really bad and terrible things like with woke. Woke really means in actuality, it means you're pro-left. It means you're pro-race baiting, race identity stuff. You recognize liberal ideas that black people are all victims, white people are all racist, we're supremacist and things like that. Like lots of woke things come from there, come from like the alphabet community. You got to recognize people's oppression points and say, hey, alphabets are above straight people, black people are above white people, you know, like females are always victims, listen and believe, a lot of stuff like that. It just essentially means you adhere to the liberal propaganda and their lifestyle and the way that they treat all their politics. It's race baiting, it's gender baiting, it's all that stuff. And that's the real definition of it. And I'm sure that's going to come out in this show. I mean, it's not really something I've seen yet. I don't know if it's even out yet. It's coming soon, but I highly doubt this is going to be mocking woke stuff as much as it should. I could actually see this being funny if it was a big parody, if it was on an actual comedy channel that was willing to goof on woke people who have gone totally off the deep end. Like, yeah, that actually could be a good idea. I could see the humor in it if it was made by some really funny people, like if a Dave Chappelle type character made a woke show like goofing on liberals and Democrats and their far left stuff. Like that could be interesting. That would be fun and good to watch. Or for another example, I think something else similar would be like the Portlandia people. Portlandia was a show that goofed on Portland a lot. That city is, of course, far left, and they goofed on all the hipsters there and all the kinds of, like, you know, rich white people going to brunch, different jokes about things like that. Like, if they made a Portlandia style woke show, that would be hilarious. But in this day and age, that's not going to happen. And I don't even think, like, a Portlandia show would happen in this day and age. Like, Dave Chappelle wouldn't be able to make his original show in this day and age because you just can't really make fun of these guys anymore. And that's why I predict this show will be like that too. So with all that said, let's read on and see what the gist is. It says, a new Hulu original series is set to premiere this fall, and it features some extremely relevant content. The Hulu series Woke will debut September 9th and will feature actor Lamorne Morris, otherwise known as the character Winston from New Girl, in the lead role. Woke tackles issues that have gripped the country over the past few months, including systemic racism and police brutality. However, the heavy topics are approached in a surreal, absurd manner that serves to dispel tension while getting to the heart of the problems. It's a bit of a leap to make such a bold series as Woke promises, but maybe it'll be exactly what we need. Well, I can already tell it's not. I don't want to get a full declaration of that. I will give it a chance. This is something I'd be interested in watching, maybe even reviewing here on the show. If you guys are interested in that, say review Woke in a comment below and hit the like button too. If this video blows up, I'll review this show. But for now, it's not looking good. They're already talking about systemic racism and police brutality, which are basically myths. These are basically conspiracy theories from the left wingers. They like to say all of the things we believe are conspiracies, which aren't. We back up our things with facts, but their facts are not real. I mean, systemic racism is not proven. This is just a claim that our system is super racist, but they have yet to point out any points where there's racist laws or rules or things that are in the system that are racist. And the same with police brutality, a similar thing where it's like, sure, there are a few cops that have been arrested and have been brutal to people, but that's very rare this day and age. It hardly ever happens. And nothing proves that more than the cases these kinds of woke people intend to bring up. They can't find actual pure police brutality cases. Like, there's not real instances of cops just beating people up for no reason. No, really what they have to do is take cases where an arrest goes wrong because the person's resisting and fighting the cops, and then they film the last 10 seconds and act like the cops just beat the guy up or arrested him for no reason. Like, that's how the left operates. It's not based on reality. We can prove them wrong. But when they call us conspiracy theorists, it's just like a empty word, when really they're the ones kind of coming up with these bogus ideas. Woke tells the story of Keith, a black cartoonist set to break into mainstream success. Despite the current climate displaying thinly veiled racism, Keith prefers to not rock the boat and routinely veers away from any political or social messages in his artwork. Like Keith says in the original series trailer, he likes to keep it light. Keith's outlook on life is shaken when one day he's roughly arrested while minding his own business, though the entire incident is a misunderstanding. It affects Keith profoundly, so much so that he begins to see inanimate objects come to life in the form of his own cartoons. The wisecracking cartoons follow Keith around, taking digs at microaggressions, casual racism, and blatant oppression that leads Keith on the path to being woke. Now on the verge of his new life as a celebrated cartoonist, Keith has to find a way to confront the new ideas he's been exposed to without destroying all that he's worked for. Okay, I don't know. Guy talking to cartoons that are telling him about racism? It sounds really weird to me. It sounds really lame to me. It sounds dumb. And what else? His name's Keith. That's an interesting name. And he wants to keep it light. And then all of a sudden, these guys say there's microaggressions and casual racism. I mean, casual racism, just think about that term. It's like light racism, like mild racism. Like, is racism even really that bad anymore? If you just saying someone's name wrong is racism, like, you're basically neutering the term where it means nothing. Like, you're made it so it's not even that bad. So when you call someone racist in the future, you're like, okay, so they said someone's name wrong, or they accidentally, you know, wore the wrong hat. Like, that was a black culture hat. You can't wear your hat backwards. So that's casual racism. And then blatant oppression. I mean, there's no oppression in America, dude. We're not in a Soviet Union, communist, like way back World War II country. There's no oppression here, dude. Like, you're oppressing yourselves. You're just believing you're a victim so much you feel oppressed. And microaggressions, I mean, that's just like casual racism. It's like microaggressions, casual racism. It's like you've taken aggression and racism and made it mean nothing. I mean, if it's a microaggression, is it even worth mentioning? I don't think so. I think we're all adults and we should be able to say, hey, let's grow up and get our crap together and act like real adults. Woke was developed by Keith Knight and Marshall Todd and was based on Knight's life and artwork as a famed political cartoonist, along with the familiar face of Lamorne Morris. Woke will feature comedic stars such as Blake Anderson, Sasheer Zamata, T. Murph, and Laura Goldie. Okay, I haven't heard of most of these guys. I have heard of the main guy from the New Girl show. Not a big fan. Pretty hipster show, but definitely funny. Had some merits. Had some funny actors in it for sure. And this is another funny actor. Blake Anderson is from one of my favorite shows, Workaholics. So seeing him in this show is going to make me want to give it a little bit of a chance. I'm not having high hopes. I could see these guys going woke too, but yeah, Workaholics fame, I mean, that's a pretty big deal. The Hulu original series will have Jay Dyer as showrunner and executive producers, Mo Marable, Aisha Carr, Richie Schwartz, John Will Gluck, and Eric Christian Olsen, alongside Knight and Todd. For the pilot episode of Woke, Kate Schumacher will also serve as EP. Woke will run for 8 episodes. So that's the story. That is the new show, Woke. It's a black guy talking to cartoons that tell him about microaggressions. I mean, do you need to hear any more about this story? You know, do you like it? Do you want to see it? I don't know, man. But if you guys want, I will review a few episodes. I will check it out and see how bad it is. We could have some more videos about it if it's necessary. If you're interested, make sure you comment that below. Say, review Woke, watch Woke. Let's have more Woke videos. That'll be interesting and fun. I love finding new topics and giving you guys content that you like. Also, if you want that, make sure you hit the like button. If this video gets, say, 2,000 likes, I'll go ahead and do it. That's not that much. There's many, many thousands of you guys watching these videos every day. Thanks for that, by the way. I really appreciate you guys watching, liking, commenting, taking a moment to check out our sponsors when you can. All of that stuff helps the channel. You're helping feed my family. You're keeping me happy and healthy and fed. And we really appreciate that at the No BS household. So you guys are the best. Have a great day. Thanks for your time. Enjoy it and see you on the next video.